Good morning, everyone. This is day one of the Super Casual Jam. We're going to be making a game using PlayFab over 2 days. I'm really excited. I have a really fun idea that I'm going to be sharing with you. And we're going to be using Unity to do this, C#. We're going to be making our assets in Maya, maybe some Blender. And by the end of the weekend, we should have a game to play. So the idea I have for the game is I'm going to be using some assets from the game I've been working on, my main game Strain, and I have a character who's rigged and working, so I can use this character to animate, and I want to do like a 3D platform game, but the movement's in two dimensions, so we're going to be viewing it from the side, but it's going to look 3D. I think it will look really cool, and it'll be fun to try doing a game in this style. I'm hoping it's something that can be done in 2 days. We will find out. So let's start by bringing in some of Unity's components that I like to work with. So we want Cinema Machine, we're gonna want post-processing, we're gonna want some Dotween. I like doing folders that are like 1, 3D, 2, materials, 3, images, 4, audio, 5, prefabs, 6, scenes, 7, scripts, 8, ports. So the first thing we're gonna wanna do is get the character moving around in a environment. So here's gonna be our plan. Super casual jam plan. Import the character, which we did. Get character to move around in an environment, stopping at walls, like hitting the ground, obviously. And then doing actions would be cool. Punching, if we're gonna make it a fighting game. Jumping, running, enemies, health for player and enemies. Varied attacks, stamina, maybe like a start and finish, score, win. Well, let's start with those things. I think the first step is to give her a rigid body, give her an animation. Next up, we'll want punching. That's gonna be best. Jumping, we're gonna want. That might be good for jumping up and down. These are kind of cool. Okay, so first of these guys, I wanna make sure that they're humanoid, they're configured. The animation is looping and matching the original position of things. These will make sure that it loops, that it goes, repeats the pose that it started in, so it's not like moving around in the scene. And then we're gonna add jump up, which I'm gonna rename to jump up. Or match this to the Unity's humanoid character so that our rig will be able to work just the same way as the one in the animation and then sync up nicely. Running for running, that one needs adjustment here. Jumping up. Jumping down, and we're gonna want a rigid body. So this is gonna be a little tricky. Let's put this inside of a, and then put the rigid body. I think I'm gonna do it on this. I'm gonna do a, and we want it to be the exact height of her. Here we are so far walking around the scene. Okay, the way that we did this was by putting a nav mesh on our scene using Unity's AI. And you can see it here. This shows where the colliders are. So these are static objects. You can see here, I've set them to static in the inspector. And in our navigator, if you click on the object, I say that these ones are not walkable and the ground object is walkable. Then when I bake it, the agent here, which we put on the character, over here on our capsule that's surrounding our character, we have a navmesh agent. And that will now know that that blue area is a walkable space. Then in our code, what we did, we set that up. We got the navmesh agent from our character. I got a near distance of how far the character should be to stop. And then on update, we get the, if the mouse button gets clicked, we get a raycast screen to point, screen point to ray. We get that hit point, set that as a destination. Then when during an update again, if they're in the walking state, which we set here, then and their distance is less than the near distance to their destination, then we set them back to idle. And so that, once again, looks like this. Not too bad. I also adjusted some of the nav mesh options here so that the character would turn around faster. I'm using angular speed. We set the speed and the acceleration to match correctly with the animation. We can even get her to come forward. What I could do is put invisible obstacles if I don't want her to be able to go sort of deeper into the scene. But I don't think we need to worry about that. I think it kind of looks good as it is. We have now a camera following our movement. We used Cinema Machine. We put in a virtual camera and we have no look at. We have the follow connected to the character. And after some trouble, found out. Thank you to chat for the suggestion of using world space. That way it doesn't lock to the character's rotation and it can smoothly go back and forth. We also put in a test building here to see how that works. We experimented with doing it in a orthographic view, but I think we're going to start with perspective and maybe do an option switch between down the road, but we're going to stick to perspective for now. We now have our character searching boxes. Basically, if you look at our code, in our update function, we check if the raycast hits the object. The object is on a certain layer called pickup. If it hits an object on the pickup, then we will check if we're far away from it. If we are, we'll set that as a destination, get the player walking again. But if we're right nearby it, we'll just make sure that the character is looking at it, and then we'll say that we've reached the item. Otherwise, we'll wait till our character reaches the item while they're walking. And here, when they start searching, they will do the animation. And within the animation itself, over here in Unity, in the animator, we have an event. But here we have an event on the animation. And so on our animator, we have a script anim controls where it says done searching. So once we're done searching, we add that to our inventory and update it, delete the object from the scene, and we set our current target to nothing, and we set our player to be null again. So, or the current game object to be null. So here's what it looks like. She goes down, she starts searching the object, and then once she gets to the kind of done point in the animation, it disappears, added to her inventory, and she stands up. She's within the collider of this, so she doesn't have to start walking towards it. She just bends over and picks it up. We'll start searching through and picks it up at the end of that. And voila. There we go. So now we're going to change these over to be a piece of rubble so they look correct. I think our next steps are going to be a day-night cycle and a health stat that will go down over time. Then we'll need to make sure that there's a reason for the loop. So like at night, there's going to probably be other people coming out that might attack you, or maybe health will go down faster. But first we need the day-night cycle and the health going down. We now, as you can see, have a health bar. The health slowly goes down over time. And if it goes to zero, we get a game over and we go back to the title screen that we added. So for the title screen, we basically made a simple scene with just a button to quit the game and to start the game. As for the canvas, we made a canvas on the both of those two scenes with an overlay and a canvas group that will fade in and out to make the scene feel a little bit more dramatic, a little bit more pretty. And on the character itself, we added a world space canvas. Let me find that. Sorry, I added it instead, not on the main game object, but on the body. So here it is. This way, it pins to the character's top piece of the spine, kind of like this area, so that if they're bending over or if they're looking around, the height will match this area. So looking down, looking around, and then I put a script on that to ensure that it faces the camera and stays centered on the player. So let's take a look. So here from the title screen, it fades in. You can quit with that. You can start the game with play. Fades in, and now we have our player walking around with this health bar. When we pick it up, it follows the player. When that hits zero, it will fade out and go back to the title screen. I don't have yet a falling down animation, but I think that would be a good one. Same with, like, I don't think we should be able to click or interact with anything once we get to zero health. We also want to be able to use the items in our inventory here. We have two bags of chips. In a moment, we'll have three. And if we use them, we'll have hotkeys attached to them. And if we use them, that should restore some health. We'll have the game over animation on the character and then the health bar. We have put in a bed. It's a little bit messy. The character can go over here, gets into bed. Kind of looks like she's getting into bed. Kind of makes sense. But importantly, health bar goes up. And when it's done, she's back up on her feet, ready to go. And if she goes and she's partway through sleeping, then, and we get up, it continues to go back down when she's not resting. We put in some rubble, so now when she goes and digs through that, it makes a little bit more sense than just a cube. She'll find an item. Can't see it here because it's dark, but it's chips. If we press one, restores health, stays up for a minute until it goes down again. So we just imported some assets. We're going to start bringing those together and putting together the level a bit better. I also want to do it so that when she looks for items in the rubble, that she'll find different things. We brought in some assets. We started making it look kind of cool. Some assets worked better than others, but I think we're off to a good start. We are now going to import PlayFab. So, and we're going to get the PlayFab SDK for Unity. There's that. And then there's the Unity Editor Extension Asset Pack. So we're going to bring both of those into the project when we're not in play mode. Import. And the other one, import. And I've logged into my PlayFab account over here. We're going to make a new studio. Studio is going to be called Void C91, VoID C91, name of the virus in the game. So let's save that studio info. And we're going to be setting it up in our game. So I have it here with my other studios I've set up here. And we are going to make our title. I think I'm going to call it that for now. That'll be the code name for it until it's got a final name. And we can make it a revival simulation, maybe. Single player, free to play, and Windows. Save title. Once you have those two things in, you can go to Window, PlayFab, Editor Extensions, and then you can use this part here to log into your account. So I'm going to do that without you guys peeking. So when you go to the Settings, API Features, you're going to want to allow Client to Post Player Statistics. That should give me the access to save and load. So now we're set up to do PlayFab. We're going to do a few more things today, little touch-ups, and then I think we're going to start tomorrow off by implementing a login with PlayFab, saving and loading with PlayFab, and then we'll put in the last parts of the game tomorrow.